Hello, everyone. My name is Karthik Muthaya, and I'm from the Azure Identity Advanced Cloud Engineering team at Microsoft. As an administrator, you may have to troubleshoot why hybrid Azure AD join devices have failed the join process. First step would be to check the device status by typing dsregcmd/status in your command prompt. This will help you to identify the current status of the device. In this case, the device is domain joined, but not Azure AD joined. So let us try to join this device in debug mode. So type dsregcmd /join/debug. This will try to join the device in debug mode, helping us to identify what could be the possible reason for the failure of the join process. From the output, you can see that the device is unable to reach the domain controller, or it doesn't have the necessary line of sight to the domain controller. This phase is called the pre-check phase. This is an important criteria for the device to go through the joining process. One more way to identify the same error can be by navigating to Event Viewer and then to Application and Service Logs. And then to Microsoft, Windows, scroll all the way down to User Device Registration, and then select the admin logs. Select the recent warning that appeared during our join process check. Expand the error message, and you can see the same error message, which is there is no connection to the domain controller. So there is one more way you can troubleshoot this again by leveraging the DSREG tool. The link for the same will be available in the description of this video. This tool helps to troubleshoot different issues such as Azure AD joined or Azure AD registered or hybrid joined devices and various other device related issues. In this case, we are going to be troubleshooting hybrid Azure AD joined devices. So select option 3. The tool does the necessary checks, and it will let us know what could be the possible reason for this failure again. So once the test is completed, we can see that the error message is still the same. The line of sight to the domain controller is not available. This is because I have specifically blocked the line of sight to the domain controller using a firewall outbound rule. So once this rule is deactivated, the join process can succeed. The next phase in the troubleshooting is called the discover phase. In this phase, ideally, the issues might be related towards service connection endpoint failures or certain other endpoint failures, such as the metadata endpoint or certain Azure AD endpoints as well. So leveraging the previous three methods of looking at error codes and also looking at deep dive logs through the event viewer, you can narrow down the issues by identifying the right error code and correlating them against the most common error codes and the publicly available error codes during this specific phase. Some of the common error codes are for the auto join failures and for network errors and also for HTTP errors. The next phase is called as the authentication phase. This content applies specifically for federated authentication, not for managed authentication. Usually the errors are related towards trying to acquire an access token from the device registration resource. Some of the common errors for this phase are towards the ADAL protocol or towards the timeout that might happen while trying to retrieve the access token. You can again correlate the error codes that you're receiving from the logs and then try to identify the right solution for the same. The next phase is called as the join phase. During this phase, the errors might be related towards the registration process failing for specific reasons, which could be with the authentication, or it could be the connection failures as well, or it could be related to the TPM or network or the auto join failures. Some of the common error codes are listed here. You can try to correlate them again from the previous three methods and try to identify if the device has failed during this phase of the joining process. Similarly, you can leverage the same process for Azure AD joined devices as well. The intention of this video is to help you troubleshoot your device registration failures and joining process failures better, leveraging the DSREC tool, the event viewer, and also the DSREC commands, which can help you narrow down the root cause and find a solution better. Hopefully this session was useful. Thank you for joining today's session. Have a nice day.